So it's a sunny day. We haven't got rain. Rain's forecast for tomorrow, so I'm going to take advantage of the sun shining. Get in and split some of these Dactylorhizas, the hardy orchids. The clumps have got a bit congested. So it's really, at this stage we can do it. Ideally I would have liked to have done it maybe a few weeks ago, but the weather's not allowed me. So this is the clump I'm going to tackle just now. It's really getting quite congested and it will start to go off. There's just so many. So let's get going and I'll go and get the equipment to get it lifted and split. So with a big spade and a fork and a small spade and a fork, I'll go and start the excavation to see if I can get them up with minimal damage to that and the other plants. Now if we just come round, you'll see there's some Salmisias in amongst there, so I'll probably have to lift them as a matter of course as I go through and replant them as well. So it's going to be a bit of a delicate operation. First thing I'll do is look to see where the edge of the rock is. There's a rock here, you see. Right down there. Edge of the rock, there we go. I'm running right down the rock, so with the small trowel initially. Down with the, well maybe the fork's the better bit. Spade might slice something. Fork you can only stab it with. Right down. As far as I can. A bit of movement. Can I see any movement? I can see the shadow of the Salmisias. Movement in the Salmisias. So we're certainly getting up in the Salmisia. There is no doubt, working with this, that I'm going to do a bit of damage to something, or some of the orchids, but yeah, I think I'll get my damage there. Work away to do the same around here. I'm really am getting down the whole fork depth. See, now we can maybe try the spade. I'm seeing something. So not only that, but in the middle here, you can see there's another Salmisia. So it's almost, it's going to have to come up. It's working around. Initially with the fork, the loosened fork does less harm. One thing you do notice about Dactylorhizas, the roots gather together. You know, they tangle in amongst each other. It does form a clump, but it really is big. Oh, I hit a stone. That was sore. Rhododendron in here as well. I think it's going to have to come up. Okay, so decided when this comes up, it's got to be big, but it needs something bigger than just that tray. So get a wheelbarrow there to get the clump up. I can put it in the wheelbarrow. Really not far from the surface. Inevitably this will happen, where our bits get broken off. There's other big roots in here. There's a young offset. So must be getting close to getting this other one up. Rhododendron and everything in here. Get this. Poor little rhododendron out. That's one I'll renew from cuttings, but we'll get it out and get it replanted. So where are we at? Yeah. Oh, success. Wowie. Another. And now the order of the day. This one's come up with a Solmissia. Oh, King's Crevins. Built my bone. It's not the great big fat roof going through here is the problem. Must be some of the trees, so they can well do without that root. And I can do without it being in this bed, to be honest. It's the other side of that big root. Another clump. So that's much of it lifted into that now, so next phase is to start splitting it off.